so much time saying that we had lost this debate that they forgot about the fundamental flaws in their case. They failed to respond to our basic burdens in this debate. We had to show these two things. First, the trade unions were completely ineffective right now to protect the best interests of workers. And secondly, as we have shown, that we have clear alternatives and different paths that avoid all of the fundamental harms that we have in trade unions. I will show you why we think that side proposition is in both of these levels the superior side of the house. To my first contention, are trade unions an effective mechanism? And first of all, we heard the trade unions have a very clear incentive to please their workers. That was the overarching response that we heard to all of our case. Two responses throughout this debate. First of all, they completely neglected the fact that workers cannot exit the unions. That's the analysis that we gave you. That they have things like quotas that we have in places like Mexico. That they have things like pressure over their employers, which means that if you do not belong to the union, you cannot simply belong to that certain profession. Completely unresponded throughout the debate. But the significance of this means is that they don't have to necessarily always stand in the best interests of the workers. They have no choice but to continue being in the union. Insofar as they mentioned that unions have things like elections and so on, that we think that these elections are completely illegitimate when the members of the unions have to stay in the union and have to please the current structure of the union if they ever wish to stay. So we don't think that workers actually have any type of meaningful power of leverage within their union. But this point was extremely significant. Why is that? Because the fact that they don't have the actual incentive to please the workers of their union brings all of the harms that we outlined throughout this debate. It means that unions care far a lot more about saving face and maintaining credibility in the overall political sphere so that they can pursue their overarching political interests, not particularly the interests of workers. That was the precise analysis that we gave as to why unions are so fundamentally inflexible. Like, the response that we heard was extremely simplistic. We think that decreasing the wages is always bad. No, it's not always bad. It's fundamentally necessary, and unions are hindering that right now. That's why we have things like massive close down of factories in places like Italy. What that means is that the average worker is being harmed by the trade union because he has no employment to begin with. So they don't stand for the best interests of the workers. But finally, we heard no real engagement with the analysis that we gave you on the third world. Why the fact that they have a monopoly on the hiring and firing decisions in places like India means that the opt cost of hiring is too high, but secondly, that they have no actual incentive to belong to the formal economy. They simply asserted that they have no capacity to do so, no analysis as to why not. So having proven all of the harms of trade unions, do we actually have an alternative that's increasing in significance right now? That we say yes for many meaningful reasons. First of all, the fact that we have a functioning structure of democracy. They said no, like democracies are not necessarily functional. Plenty of responses that went completely unresponded. The fact that there is a clear trend in, firstly, that the media has more influence and that people can actually be aware of the things that happens, which means that citizen-initiated agendas can further be pursued. But furthermore, the fact that more awareness means that we can cap things like boycotts that we told you in third speaker and responded. But finally, we think that on the question of dictatorships and autocracies, we think that trade unions are unlikely to make Robert Mugabe change his mind. So the question is quite simple. Trade unions do nothing to help the workers and are worse than the alternatives. We win this debate.